Hey everybody, it's Prince Pandora back again with another video, and today I want to talk to you guys about how to create a story, or rather, the trials and tribulations you'll have to go through to create your story. Let me start off by saying making the actual story part isn't hard at all. There's the idea, the plan, and then the execution. But a lot of people always get stuck on the dream portion of it and never move on to the plan, and never move on to the execution. And it's understandable. I was there myself at one point. I just had all of these ideas. I kept talking about them. I kept sharing them with friends, but I never did anything to put actual effort behind those ideas until much later. And while it's understandable and it happens to a lot of people, your story won't be anything if you keep it in the dream phase. A lot of people are scared that a lot of people won't like their work, or they won't get the validation that they hope for. And to be honest, just take the leap, Miles. It's just a leap of faith. Wherever you land at, you have to land there and you have to grow from that point. Sometimes you might land at a horrible spot. Sometimes you might be better than the rest. But a lot of times you just have to take that opportunity and make that jump. And I can understand that some people are terrified of the validation or criticism that they may get and people really don't like it. But let me tell you, as someone who got their series absolutely tore apart when I first started, it's going to be okay. Now, with that being said, a lot of people oftentimes confuse what consistency really means. In most people's eyes, consistency means doing everything every day at 100%, giving it your absolute best. And that's not true in the slightest. You see, to me, consistency means doing something at least every day, or putting some effort in. It doesn't mean you have to go at 100% every day. Some days you might go 5%. Other days you might go 10. Some days 70. It's things like that. That is what consistency means. It means doing something and doing what you can. And that's one of the things that we represent here at Ogo, consistency. You see, a lot of the team, they have families, they have other responsibilities that take them away from their mana or whatever story they're working on. But they still make time to drop quality chapters every month or bi-monthly. So in my eyes, people just have to make the time for themselves to actually do it. And it's not you get all the free time in the world, you just do what you can and drop something of quality. And that goes into my next point of quality. It's okay to restart your work, but at a certain point in time, you gotta just keep going with what you got. Any mistakes you might have made in chapter one, don't go back and re-edit the chapter. Every time you do that, it's just going to take away more time for you to work on your other chapters. When you get time, just go back and work on it. But when you have a story that you're trying to consistently put out, it is best to learn from the mistakes of your previous chapter and do better in the next chapter. You can't get caught up in the professionalism or perfectionism that is going to happen when you do your pages. There's a lot of stuff in chapter one that I want to redo, but I understand that I need to keep moving forward because, well, if I went back and redid chapter one, I wouldn't be on chapter eight right now. Ultimately, what I'm trying to say is that no one is stopping you from creating your story except for yourself. And I understand for some people, they might have mental illnesses. You know, some people might actually have health problems, and that's understandable. I can understand that for real. But some people might have mental illness problems. Some people might have ADHD, autism, things of that nature. And how I want to put it is that I think we're all going through something. And I think you can use what you're going through as a muse to create something very entertaining, creative, or just something that speaks to you or whatever. So if you're scared or you're nervous, I wouldn't be. I can understand it. Trust me, I understand it because I've been there too. Not only 2 years ago, I've been in that same position. I'm sure many artists have been in that same position. But that's the thing between you and many artists. Well, I say you, but I don't know, like, if it's you per se, because you might give up. But regardless, times are tough for everybody. You got to sometimes truck through it and understand that this takes a lot out of you. Not like energy, whatnot. It takes a lot of time to put forward into creating manga, comics, anything of that nature. You're sacrificing time to create something that you believe in. And I think you got to understand that it comes with those responsibilities. Sometimes you ain't going to have fun because you got to work on this stuff. But I will say, growing And learning is such amazing rewards because it's like in the process of doing it, it's a pain in the butt, it's tedious. But after when I'm done and I see what I've improved on or what I created, I'm like, oh, damn, Pandora made this? Oh, shit, nigga, Pandora? Oh, you know, just hyping myself up. It's like, it's things like that that kind of keeps you going when you're making these stories. Because you got to understand, you know, again, you won't have all the free time in the world. And it's just going to be on you to make it happen. Because no one's going to bet on you if you're not going to bet on yourself.